Welcome to my channel Chemistry Not Mystery. You can also visit to my website chemistrynotmystery.com. This video is also available in Hindi and you can get its link in the description box. So today we are going to discuss factors affecting SN1 reaction. We have already discussed the SN1 reaction mechanism in very much detail. You will get its link in the description box. Let's take an overview of SN1 reaction mechanism. It is a two-step mechanism. In the first step, carbocation formation takes place. When leaving group leaves the molecule and the bond between carbon and leaving group breaks. After the breaking of this bond, you will get the carbocation. Carbocation is the product for the first step of the reaction and it will act as a reactant for the second step of the reaction. In the second step, nucleophile attack to this carbocation. This bond is forming in this stage of the molecule. Once the bond is formed between carbon and nucleophile, you will get your product. So how do you identify which one is the intermediate? Intermediate is the molecule which you will get as a product in one step of the reaction, and the same molecule act as a reactant for the second step of the reaction. Will be your intermediate. So carbocation here is your intermediate for SN1 reaction mechanism. And these stages where bonds are not fully formed. You can see in this molecule the bond between carbon and leaving group is breaking. In this stage of the molecule, bonds are not fully formed. So this stage is the transition state 1, and the next where the bond between carbon and nucleophile is still forming is the second transition state. Now let's try to draw an energy profile diagram for SN1 reaction mechanism. So when you draw reaction coordinate on the x-axis and on y-axis, we are going to plot energy. You will get this type of graph. We can divide this graph into two equal halves. First half will represent first step of the reaction and second half will represent the second step of the reaction. In the first step of the reaction, the highest peak that represents transition state, because transition state always has highest energy. And this is the product for the first step of the reaction and it will act as a reactant for the second half of the reaction. And this peak represents transition state. And this is your product. So when you see the energy difference between the reactant and the transition state represents the activation energy. This is Ea1 is the activation energy for the first step of the reaction, and similarly you will get Ea2 activation energy for the second step of the reaction. Step with the highest activation energy is the rate determining step. So here Ea1 is more than Ea2. So that's why first step of the reaction will be the rate determining step for SN1 reaction. Now let's discuss what are the other factors that affect the SN1 reaction. Let's discuss the type of substrate that prefer to react via SN1 reaction mechanism. Compounds that can form more stable carbocation prefer to react via SN1 reaction mechanism because carbocation is the intermediate of the reaction. These compounds can be categorized in different categories. So first category, reactive center of the carbon is more substituted, will prefer to react via SN1 reaction mechanism. For example, in this molecule, this is the reactive center of this molecule and this carbon is the tertiary carbon. Once the leaving group leaves the molecule, it results in the formation of tertiary carbocation. And this tertiary carbocation is get stabilized by the hyperconjugation. So such type of molecules prefer to react via SN1 reaction mechanism. Next category in which carbon is directly bonded to electron donating group. For example, in this molecule, this carbon is the reactive center of the molecule and it is directly bonded with OMe. OMe group is an electron donating group. Once this leaving group leaves the molecule, the formed carbocation gets stabilized by the plus M effect of this molecule. That's why such type of next category of the molecule is the carbon that is directly bonded to pi system. For example, this is the reactive carbon and it is bonded with benzene. Benzene has conjugated pi system. So formed carbocation will get stabilized by plus R effect of benzene. Similarly, in this molecule also, formed carbocation will get stabilized by plus R effect of alkene. This is the allylic carbon and this is benzylic carbon. So they both prefer to react via SN1 reaction mechanism because the formed carbocation get stabilized by plus R effect. Now let's discuss the type of leaving group that support SN1 reaction. So leaving group always should be good, but how do you identify which leaving group is good? So there is a rule, weak nucleophile are better leaving group. For example, if you are going to compare between Rx and ROH. In Rx, X is the leaving group and in ROH, OH may be the leaving group. So how do you identify which will react via SN1 reaction mechanism or which will leave first? So when you compare the electronegativity of halogen and oxygen, because halogens are more electronegative, they are less likely to share electrons with any carbon or any other molecule. That's why they are weak nucleophile. While less electronegative oxygen easily share its electron pair with a carbon. So that's why it will act as a strong nucleophile. So weak nucleophiles are better leaving group. That's why halide ion will leave first while OH minus will not leave the molecule as a leaving group. There are some other rules to identify good leaving group. Good leaving group is the molecule that stabilizes negative charge better. To stabilize negative charge better, molecule should be electronegative. It should be bigger in size. If it is bigger in size, negative charge will get dispersed over a bigger volume as compared to the smaller one. So bigger molecules, more electronegative ones are good leaving group. So let's try to apply these rules to compare the leaving group ability of fluoride, chloride, bromide and iodide in different alkyl halides. So when you compare between them, you come to know that fluorine is the smallest in size while iodide is the biggest in the size. So iodide being bigger in size can disperse negative charge better, so that's why iodide can leave the molecule easily and they are good leaving group. This leaving ability of the molecule also helps us to decide the reactivity of different alkyl halides. So because iodide can leave easily the molecule, so it will react faster as compared to alkyl bromide, and alkyl bromide will react faster as compared to chloride. While the reactivity of alkyl fluoride is least among the other alkyl halides. Now come to the type of nucleophiles. Actually, the type of nucleophile doesn't affect the rate of SN1 reaction mechanism because the attack of nucleophile comes in the second step of the reaction. At the first step is the rate determining step. So mostly solvent act as a nucleophile in SN1 reaction mechanism. Now discuss the type of solvents. Which type of solvents support SN1 reaction? So mostly polar protic solvent supports SN1 reaction because they are polar in nature. They can polarize the bond between carbon and leaving group. And thus they facilitate leaving group to leave the molecule. And it also stabilizes formed intermediate. Here the intermediate is the carbocation. For example, if we take water as a solvent. And this process of solvation is also called as solvolysis. As a result of solvolysis, intermediate as well as leaving group both get stabilized. So when you compare energy profile diagram for SN1 reaction, in absence of polar protic solvent and in presence of polar protic solvent, this green graph represents the energy profile diagram for SN1 reaction in absence of polar protic solvent. And in presence of polar protic solvent, you will get this orange curve. I have drawn only half of this curve because the first step is the rate determining step. So because it stabilizes the carbocation, it also lowers the activation energy. This one was the previous activation energy. This one is the new activation energy. By lowering the activation energy, polar protic solvent supports SN1 reaction. Now try to answer this question. Find out the correct order of solvolysis, means SN1 reaction. And these are the reactants. And these are the options. You have to post your answer in the comment box. And if you have any doubt, you can post them in the comment box. And don't forget to like and share this video. And please subscribe to my channel and press the bell icon to get a notification. You can also join my Telegram channel or follow me on Twitter or Instagram. Thanks for watching. Keep learning. Stay safe.